Hello and greetings from Iceland, but this will only be a short update now or a follow-up from my long video yesterday where I covered the situation around Grindavík in detail and I'm linking to that video. But our experts have been feeding us with some new information today and although there are no surprises there, we did get some important pieces of information in the puzzle. And first, we learned that 3,800 earthquakes have been detected where the magma intrusion takes place. Between those two huge rows of craters, north of Grindavík, just by the Blue Lagoon, and a power plant, and those thousands of earthquakes occurred in this week alone. But more importantly, we were told that a magma dike is in the making, and an eruption seems therefore more and more likely, as the magma is obviously trying to find its way through the crust at the different locations. So how can we, the armchair experts, do our own research? And it's of course through the seismometers, but those of you who have been here with me since before the Geldingadalir eruption last year, you might remember that we could see the lateral dike from Mount Keilir back then as it was forming through the seismometers, and for a while it was playing games with us as we were chasing it. So this dike is what we will be looking for in the coming days for sure, and I'm once again linking to usual tools, but you need to know a bit about them. First, of course, we have the live view on the Icelandic weather pages, since it's our number one web for bad news. But I'm afraid that when we get so many earthquakes, our experts just can't keep up with correcting them manually, as they always do. And it's only after that when they appear on a more detailed web page, where you can sort them hour by hour. So this system isn't totally perfect, even though it's good. And then we have the option to look at them in 3D and other forms I'm linking to. But as I take a look at what's happening right now, it's a bit of a surprise. So I'm showing you this clip from my full Grindavík video. And we have this new location now teasing us. It's this little mountain called Sílingafell. It's most likely good news for the town, but terrible news for the power plant and the Blue Lagoon. But it can be a matter of only a few meters if we will get a tourist eruption or a disaster. And at this moment, it's just impossible to say where an eruption might come up if this goes all the way, like it looks now. But a dike that we can see in the making will of course be helpful as time moves on. But it's just too early now to jump to any conclusions. The earthquake pattern just changes every few hours and we haven't got any maps from our geologists about this dike they mentioned today. And it's also too early to say how big this might get, but a 20 square kilometer lava field from the old craters near the land uplift has its own history. But there is this one thing I want to mention, but an expert said the other day that even though they have all this modern tools now, like GPS and satellite data, it's very young technology, and no matter how much we know now, we don't know how the land uplift developed before the days of GPS. So reading between the lines, he was saying that what we have already seen could just as well be the tip of the iceberg. And this is getting serious, so tomorrow night there will be a citizens meeting in Grindavík preparing the people for evacuation, like last year. And I have to tell you that the situation now is by far more serious when it comes to infrastructure and the property damage than last year. This could fade out, of course, but it gets more and more unlikely. So all we can do now is to have the bulldozers ready to make barriers where possible, but most importantly, to make sure that we evacuate those places at risk swiftly when and if that time comes. And my next video will be uploaded tomorrow, where I speak about the big earthquake that we've been warned about in Reykjavik, as there are some major things happening now on the Reykjanes Peninsula. So again, feel free to use my longer video for the bigger picture around Grindavík. It's packed with information and new footage, and made in order to give myself some flexibility to do shorter news updates without repeating myself too often. And my yesterday's video tells the whole story. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.